In a filled-up plenary session on Tuesday this week, the Ugandan Parliament adopted and passed the Appropriations Bill of 2024, which had been returned by President Museveni for re-appropriation. The session was conducted under heavy security deployment around the parliamentary premises following intelligence reports pointing to unauthorized anti-corruption demonstrations.
It is a wake-up call to the institution, Parliament. It is a wake-up call to us. Why should citizens start trying to protest against Parliament and against corruption around Parliament? And this brings me to my motion. Why should members of Parliament fear debate? Why do members don't want to debate the issues of corruption at Parliament? So which other avenues remain in? Because the ideal way would be to debate. For everybody to debate, how do the citizens respond when people don't want to have these matters debated?
Regardless of the anticipated demonstrations against corruption in Parliament, legislators proceeded with the debate of the Reappropriations Bill 2024. The President's concerns were conveyed through a letter read by the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among. President Museveni criticized the reallocation practices that have been ongoing for the last four financial years, describing them as sabotaging development efforts. He urged MPs to cease this practice, highlighting the irregularity of the reallocations and citing recent corruption accusations among Parliament members.
The statement that has been given clears people that they have not stolen the money. That clears everybody that the money has not been stolen. It was allocated to different areas.
These accusations of corruption provoked mixed reactions from the MPs. However, the chairperson of the Budget Committee defended the budget cuts, stating that they were necessary to facilitate crucial activities such as the construction of schools and the procurement of ambulances.
770 billion reallocated. Nearly half of that money, 300 billion, is going to Roku, a private company that has been mismanaged by its proprietor, but they are Museveni's friends. They didn't allow me to proceed to the next point, because the next point, money was being moved from what Museveni calls debt servicing, and debt servicing there meant the war of Pinet.
Among the most contentious items reconsidered was the allocation of 300 billion shillings listed under a generic category of others. Members of Parliament clarified that this sum is intended for Rock Construction Company, a private firm, a move some MPs have deemed irregular. Despite some disagreements, Parliament ultimately passed the Appropriations Bill with the President's recommended changes amounting to 750 billion shillings, which he stated would foster development. The reconsiderations made by Parliament did not alter the final budget estimates, which remain at 72 trillion shillings. The move to return the Budget Appropriations Bill 2024 for debate signaled a lack of harmony between the executive and the legislature during budget appropriation. However, Speaker Among assured Parliament that moving forward, there will be a prior discussion with the President about the budget to ensure that number of issues are prioritized.
We've agreed we should have a meeting with His Excellency and agree on the working methods, that before the budget comes to the House, we should be able to scrutinize the budget together with His Excellency, so that we make sure that the national priorities are catered for. So we want to do that with executive.
The passage of the Appropriations Bill marks a significant step in Uganda's fiscal planning for the upcoming year, albeit one shrouded into controversy and debate over the best approach to fostering national development.